Now, delayed shipment of election materials and allegations of pre-shaded ballots. These are some of the issues that hounded overseas voting for the 2022 Philippine elections. Joining us now to give us their thoughts on the conduct of the polls are Elmer Ocampo-Casao. He's the founding president of the Institute of Integrated Electrical Engineers Abu Dhabi, and Bea Magsalin Manuel. She's an overseas Filipino who's been working in the United Arab Emirates for over 10 years. Thank you very much for joining us, both of you.
Thank you, Emirates, also for having us.
Thank you, Lexi, for having us here.
Well, okay, so let's talk about the importance of this particular election and what's at stake. I mean, we did talk to an OFW representative as well from Dubai, saying that the voter turnout was so amazing. Did you see the same sort of enthusiasm from your end of the world?
Yeah, I am definitely sure of that. I have seen enthusiasm for all of the overseas Filipino workers here in the UAE. Specifically, I voted in Abu Dhabi, and you can see the excitement among the voters. And I think it's a positive attitude among the Filipinos, because, including myself, because we are so hopeful of the turnout of these elections. And included in that is the very smooth flow of the how the Philippine Embassy and the Philippine Consulate General in Dubai have conducted the election. So I have heard so many positive responses from co-OFWs.
And how was the voter turnout? Because there are, well, according to the ABS-CBN Investigative and Research Group, there are around 1,697,215 registered overseas voters. And a lot of that is from the Middle East.
Yeah, a lot of that is from the Middle East. And I think 16% of that is coming from the United Arab Emirates, which is around more than 300,000. As of now, we haven't received any official number from the Philippine Embassy and the Philippine Consulate General, but we are confident that it is more than 30%, no, more than what we had in the past recent election.
Yeah, correct. There will be more voters turnout this year compared to the other elections. And also, Dubai has the highest, I think, among the cities in the Middle East who has the voters turnout.
And how was the campaign season on the ground? Because the representative from Dubai, he was saying that it very much echoed how it was in the Philippines in terms of, for President Bongbong Marcos held a very online sort of social media campaign, whereas for Vice President Lenny Robredo, it was very much about volunteerism and, you know, team spirit and working together. Did you find that it was much the same out there?
Yeah, the same.
Yeah, I can say that it is basically the same. I think it just differs on the methodology per se, because here we are not allowed to campaign, because that is not allowed, you know, to gather in a certain place. So that is somehow the limitation for gathered for purposes of campaigning. But of course, we have our own ways to do that. And I think most of the OFWs did that in their own ways. But the essence of volunteerism is there. Everyone is really sharing or giving all their efforts, of course, to campaign for their candidates.
Yeah, and I think all the volunteers here also in both parties are directly close with the volunteers in the Philippines. So they're sharing all the information back to back. So I think the volunteerism is there, and also the social media presence is very, very strong.
And how did the candidates, did they reach out to you? Because with Lenny, she was very much about being with the people. She was very strong also in her platform for what she wanted to do for OFWs. Did you feel that emanating from her from out there? And same with former Senator Bongbong Marcos, did you feel that he reached out to you and made you feel what exactly he was going to do for OFWs if he did win?
From my end, I believe all of the candidates really did reach out to OFWs, because they fully understand how much is the contribution of OFW in terms of the country's GDP. So we play a very important role on that, and we take pride in contributing on that part in our country's development. And specifically, we've heard the platforms of VP Lenny Robredo, and of course Bongbong Marcos. It's even published in his Facebook account or website what the platforms would be for the OFWs. And the one thing that I would like to focus on the platform of Bongbong Marcos is the hospitals for OFW, which of course we are, if he would be declared as the eventual winner, then that's something that OFW would be looking, forward to.
And Bea, an OFW, obviously as an OFW, as a voter, what were you looking for in terms of your next president, and what was lacking from the last presidency to take care of OFWs in general and your plight as well?
I think the president should, the public servant should look as OFW, not like we're just working here, because most of us here are with our families. So we want something that they will also cater for the rights or the benefits for our family. Example, the streamlining the OEC, the homeschooling here. Recently, the DepEd is not accrediting the OFW homeschoolers. So they're now have any other choices left but to bring back all their children to school because they're not accredited with the DepEd right now. So something like that, more than the those who are working, but also for the benefits of the families here.
Of course, because in the end, our beautiful, wonderful OFWs are leaving the country to find better opportunities for the families that are at home.
Yes, yeah. Exactly.
I just wanted to add on that what Bea just mentioned. I would really want the next administration to increase the budget for the Philippine Embassy and the Philippine Consulate General to have a full digitalization because of the services, because that is how we do things here in the United Arab Emirates.
Yeah.
To be at par with the government here, and of course to lessen the burden of the OFWs in scheduling the appointment, lining up for their turn to be
served, to get the paperwork
to get the paperwork done in terms of the application for the overseas employment certificate, for example. So I believe that strongly believe that full digitalization is a must. And that's something the next administration, I am hoping to for them to have an increase in the budget.
And obviously, the next administration will also be the one to open up and implement the newly appointed Department of Migrant Workers, set to begin in 2023. What are you expecting from that? Because I know that all the other agencies, it'll sort of be the umbrella where it's sort of like a go-to for everything. Are you excited for that?
Of course, we are very excited. We're very excited because we're looking at an enhanced and faster services for the overseas Filipino workers, more focused repatriation programs, for example, other aids which the overseas Filipino workers require, training, skills development, which is of course necessary and also required for us to be at par with the other expats from the other countries. And these are the things that we are so very excited about. I don't know if Bea can add something on that.
Yes, I will be definitely excited with the reintegration of the OFWs, because after working so hard for so many years here, we want to invest and go back to the Philippines to be part of our to help our economy. So we want something that they will help us or assist us in our reintegration in the Philippines, and also our families will benefit also with the hospital or other benefits, because I think it will give us a great service if they will assist us on those things.
Well, would you say that this would be President Rodrigo Duterte's parting shot to the OFW community? And how do you assess his years in office in terms of taking care of our OFWs?
Well, I can give him a very high satisfactory rating in terms of the services extended to the OFWs. That's what I am confident in sharing. No, what I have experienced when I went home to the Philippines, how the services have improved under his administration. And it's his legacy, the Department of OFW, and we can't be more excited in the next term, looking at all of the services that the Department of OFW can extend to the OFWs, of course. But I just hope that the next administration also can, give a different brand name for OFWs, which that I am advocating for, that we be called as global Filipinos, not anymore overseas Filipino workers.
Oh, so you want a rebranding of sorts, huh?
Yes, because we are confident that we are ambassadors of our country. There is only one plenipotentiary ambassador, but we are playing ambassadors of our country. And when employers choose us to be employed with them, we present our visas, we present our passport, we present our being Filipino. So we are global Filipinos.
Well, Elmer and Bea, please know that when we see you, we see the pride, we see the hard work, and we know that you are representing the Filipino people very well in your corner of the world. So no need for rebranding there, because you definitely are global Filipinos in my mind and in the minds of many Filipinos back home.
Yeah, thank you so much
for that. Thank you, Lexi.
And thank you for joining me today.